Bill number 2865 on second reading.
Please raise your right hand.
In favor. All those against? Against. With 13 affirmative votes, 8 negative votes, 0 abstention, Senate Bill number 2865 is hereby approved on second reading. Majority Leader.
Mr. President,
the Senate has just voted 13-8-0 to approve the RH bill on second reading. Thanks to the President's declaring it, certifying it as urgent, they have a chance to vote on third reading tonight as well.
Malacañang Palace, Manila, December 14, 2012. Honorable Juan Ponce, Senate President.
Well, the upper chamber is expected to proceed immediately.
Pursuant to the provisions of Article 6, Section 26 of the 1987 Constitution, I hereby certify to the necessity of the immediate enactment of Senate Bill number 2865, entitled An Act Providing for a National Policy on Reproductive Health and Responsible Parenthood, in order to address the socio-economic and environmental problems brought about by an ever-increasing population, by integrating a responsible parenthood and family planning component in anti-poverty and other sustainable development programs of the government, and to promote the people's right to health through the implementation of a comprehensive reproductive health care program. Best regards, very truly yours, Benigno S. Aquino III, Capi Furnace, Honorable Feliciano R. Belmonte Jr., Speaker, House of Representatives, Quezon City, Secretary Manuel N. Mamba, PLLO.
Mr. President, with the reading of that certification, I move that Senate Bill 2865 be approved on third and final reading.
I move to second the motion.
Nominal voting, Secretary.
The Honorable Senators Angara.
May I explain my vote, Mr. President?
Okay, then in that case, I withdraw.
Yes, Mr. President, I vote yes to this measure, because it's an affirmation of our basic human rights, especially the rights of women and the right to reproductive health. At the moment, we have to respond to the challenges that threaten our country. 1,000 women continue to die yearly during pregnancy and childbirth. About 150,000 children are born from teenage mothers every year. Women who cannot support their children put them into orphanages or labor work. We have almost 2 million orphans from 0 to 17 years of age, and about 4 million child laborers ages 5 to 17. About 9,000 Filipinos are afflicted with HIV, AIDS, and at 100 million people, Mr. President, were the 12th most populous country in the world. These numbers will continue to rise. The RH Bill's provisions on family planning information and services, emergency obstetric care, and reproductive health education intend to respond to these challenges. We have to consider that maternal deaths due to pregnancy and childbirth are unique. It only happens to women, Mr. President. Without family planning, women will continue to bear children As they do so, they continue to be exposed to the risk of life-threatening complications. And so they will need to have access to obstetric services. Failure to provide such services, Mr. President, constitutes discrimination against women because it is only women who face this risk of dying once pregnant. We have already discussed, Mr. President, the United Nations General Assembly approval of the Convention on the Elimination of Discrimination Against Women, CEDAW, and I will not stress that too much, Mr. President. But it means that we must not discriminate against women. And we must do everything to prevent maternal deaths and provide family planning information and services to them. Today, I do not just speak as a long-time advocate of public health regulation and legislation. And the principal author of PhilHealth and the Magna Carta of Public Health Workers, today I speak both as a lawyer and a legislator. I acknowledge the grave concerns of my fellow Roman Catholics and our leaders in the clergy. I do not see anything in the RH bill that forget the moral dimensions of sexual relations, which undermine the Filipino family. In the first place, the RH bill does not legalize abortion. Secondly, unwanted pregnancies are the leading cause of 500,000 abortions yearly. Thirdly, the RH bill does not impose any family planning method, but leaves the Filipino couple free to choose whichever method they want. And finally, to withdraw from enacting the RH bill because one's church opposes it is inconsistent, Mr. President, with the principle of separation of church and state. We have to consider that not all Filipinos are Catholics. While Catholics comprise 70% of our population, we also have Muslims, Protestants, Buddhists, non-believers, and others. Regardless of religion, it is the right of the state to enact the bill for the best interest of our nation, especially of our mothers, our wives, our sisters, and daughters. So, Mr. President, today I vote as a Filipino, a lawyer, a public health advocate, a husband, a father, and grandfather. Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Thank you, Governor Angara. Whether birth control will improve living standards, whether there is